Lauren and I are honored to serve as co-chairs of the Answer the Call Associate Committee, which is a committee composed of dedicated young professionals and first responders who work to honor our fallen heroes and raise funds to support our heroes' families. If anyone in the room is interested in learning more about our committee, please come chat with either of us or any staff member tonight, or feel free to reach out after the gala.
It is now our privilege to introduce you to one of our fellow associate committee members, Caitlin Leavey. Kate is the daughter of FDNY Lieutenant Joseph Leavey, who made the ultimate sacrifice in the line of duty on September 11th, 2001.
Good evening, my name is Kate Leavey. It is an incredible honor to be here with you all today to share my stories, thanks to the unwavering support from Answer the Call. When I was 10 years old, I lost my dad Joe, a lieutenant with the New York City Fire Department. He was assigned a Ladder 15 at the South Street Seaport. My dad graduated from the Fire Academy in 1982. He was first assigned to Engine 23 and then Ladder 4. When he was promoted to lieutenant in February of 1998 and assigned to Ladder 15, I was 7 years old. The firehouse was his second home, and I loved to visit. Whether it was for holiday events, family events, or stopping by during one of our many field trips to Midtown and then later Lower Manhattan. When my dad wasn't at the firehouse, he was home as Mr. Mom. He was always there to coach my sports games, take me on field trips, help out with Girl Scout outings, and playing with everyone in the neighborhood. Many people in our town called him the mayor of Pelham, where he always gave back in our community, whether it be at our church, school, or supermarket. In fact, going to the supermarket with him was never a quick and easy feat, as a quick trip always turned into an hour-long outing where he would be socializing with everyone. On September 11th, 2001, I was in fifth grade and in school that morning when I found out the World Trade Center site was attacked. I immediately knew my dad would be there. After all, it was our favorite place our family would visit during one of our family field trips, and my dad admired those buildings. I remember when it was time for pickup, my dad not being there, even though I knew it was his day to pick me up. I waited there for him, listening for his chain and watching for his long strides as he would come up the hill to my school. Instead, I was met with crowds of parents picking up their children in chaos. I remember the panic in the area and parents anxious to embrace their kids. I didn't know what to make of it, and I tried every mite of my 10-year-old brain to tell myself my dad would be home, but then he must have just gotten called into work last minute. Coming home that day was filled with so much shock and confusion. I remember trying to put all the pieces together to understand what possibly could be happening. I was the youngest of three, my brother was 16 and my sister 26, and we all understood what was happening differently. Amidst the chaos and confusion, I remember specifically the missing signs. I remember the missing signs we made of my dad, only to worry how people wouldn't recognize him given that only a few weeks prior he had shaved his mustache. My mom's strength and faith is what kept us through, reminding us of the man my dad was and how you do anything to get back home to us. My dad answered the call to serve, and along with 342 other active duty firefighters from the FDNY, never made it home to his family. He had responded to the South Tower and made it to the 78th floor. His voice was on the radio calls he made to dispatch that morning, where his calm voice was heard leading his colleagues on their way up. Hearing my dad's voice still all these years later is such a gift that not only makes me so incredibly proud of my dad, but has inspired me immensely to follow in his footsteps, something I know in my heart he would want me to do. In the days, weeks, and months that followed, so many people were there for me and my family with tremendous love and support, something I will never forget. The fire department showed up the most incredible way, embodying the second family my dad always talked about. And most importantly, so did Answer the Call, showing up for my family when we needed them the most. This, along with my dad's inspiration, inspired me to serve others in my own way, volunteering in my own community, working with children, especially those who've gone through a traumatic event, teaching with Teach for America, volunteering with many organizations inspired by 9/11, especially Answer the Call, and striving to educate the next generation, many with no memory that day, of the bravery and immense act of kindness that followed 9/11. When people ask me about my 9/11 story, I'm proud to not only share the incredible heroism of my dad, but also the spirit of resiliency that came out of 9/11. Or, as we would call it, America's Camp, a camp for children who lost someone that day in the line of duty, the light out of the darkness. Answer the Call's unwavering support has not only been a light for mine and many families, but also their incredible sense of support that has brought many families together, where they have spoken the word and acted upon, never forgetting. I am so honored and proud to be part of this organization's host committee, and now associate committee for the past 2 years, where I'm committed to helping the organization continue the incredible work to serve other families. Most recently, I owe Answer the Call a very sincere thank you, as they've helped me make my next chapter possible, becoming a mental health therapist. Shortly after COVID hit, I'd been teaching for about 8 years when I applied to my dream program at NYU to pursue this pathway. Paying for my way through grad school after being on a teacher's salary was no easy feat, and it was thanks to Answer the Call that eased this burden. Answer the Call's financial gifts aided me in supporting some of the many financial expenses at NYU and made this next chapter possible. I'm very proud to say that I graduated my MA in Counseling and Mental Health and Wellness in July of 2022. Now, as a mental health therapist, I aspire to provide support, especially to children and first responders. My dream is to be able to develop a program to provide counseling and group work to this population. Thank you, Answer the Call, for being there for my family when we needed you the most. Thank you for continuing to be there for my family and so many others. Thank you to all of you here tonight for supporting this incredible organization and never forgetting my dad and so many others. I truly hope to pay it forward by helping other children when they might need me the most.
Thank you so much, Kate. We are moved by your desire to pay it forward and to create a program to provide counseling to children of first responders. To assist you as you work towards that goal, Answer the Call would love to send you to the American Psychological Association's 2024 annual conference in Seattle, Washington, all expenses paid, so that you can network and learn from the best in the field.
In addition, you mentioned your dad loves his hometown of Pelham and was even called the mayor of Pelham. The admiration was mutual, as Pelham was honored to call such an incredible man one of their own. Years ago, the Pelham community dedicated the corner of Lincoln Avenue and 3rd Avenue to your dad, naming it the Joe Leavey Corner. What was once a small area has now been designed into a passive park as part of the new Hutchinson School that was built. And with the combined efforts of the Pelham Public Schools, Village of Pelham, Pelham Fire Department, and Hutchinson School PTA, we are happy to announce that they will be rededicating this area to your dad, reinstalling the original plaque, and adding a new bench in that location in honor of your dad. Thank you again, Kate, for joining us tonight, for sharing your story, and for all the good you do in the world.